Да, я предлагаю выбрать какую-то, ну, такую тему простую для примера, чтобы мы могли увидеть, как мы находим чувства, которые находятся в конфликте, и интегрировать.
Uh-huh. So Zoya suggests that, as usual, how we start any process, we pick up on a theme that's bothering you or sitting in your heart. It could be different today to last time. It could be still the same as last time, but whatever is, but something that we could use as an example that you'd feel comfortable using, you know, as an example. But usually we start with a process, something that's, either that or, like Zoe told me today, something that I'd like to bring into my life that I don't have in the future. That's also very linked, and you'll see we wrote a little chapter about it.
Right. Well, something I was thinking about that I imagine many people think about too is, I would love to change my relationship with money. So, for example, it doesn't seem to matter how much I make. The expenses are always one amount larger. So it doesn't matter if I'm working full-time and making money or not working. The expenses seem to always be larger than the income, regardless of the income.
То есть, сколько бы он ни работал, всегда трата больше. Вот это, ну, у нас,
да, да,
мы хотим затронуть эту тему или все-таки лучше?
Все-таки, ну, это связано, что нам нужно просто более сфокусироваться на чувствах, которые причиняют дискомфорт по этому поводу.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. So, we need to focus on the feelings that arise and cause a discomfort with relating to what you just said. So we always find the feeling. What feeling is it?
Whenever I think about finances, I always just feel not hopeless, because I know there's always basically enough. But I just feel frustrated. Frustrated that it doesn't seem to matter what I do. I almost feel like I can anticipate that it's not going to be a large enough amount. So it's almost, I just get frustrated anticipating unknown expenses. Stuff's just going to seem to come out of nowhere. But it's not hopelessness, it's just frustration. Does that sound right?
Вот у нас есть некая заданность, в которой мы в худшем положении относительно финансовой ситуации, и есть некое устремление к лучшему положению.
Mm-hmm.
Да, и нам нужно найти две точки.
Okay. So we have like a standard that with regards to our finances, where we would like them to be.
Где мы стартуем из точки, где я якобы неудачник и должен uh-huh. добиться большего, и где якобы должен оказаться в лучшей ситуации.
Okay, so where I am the unlucky guy who needs to strive to get more. The first point where I'm this unlucky guy where I need to get to more. And that point of more where I got to where?
To прийти куда?
Where you need to arrive.
From where?
To where you need to arrive to. So you got two points. Yeah? Uh-huh.
Да, и то есть нам нужно визуализировать вот этот отрезок, где я ну, неудачник или лузер, там, как, кем я себя чувствую, mm-hmm. когда мне чего-то не достает, когда я трачу больше, чем получаю.
Okay, so we need to visualize this timeline, or like a line, this line. So from this point where I'm a loser, where I don't have enough of what I need. Yeah, and
да, и где-то где есть та точка, в которой я успешный, счастливый, и мне достаточно это income, которого я хотел.
Uh-huh. And the other point where I have enough and I'm just happy of where everything is just all right, man, it's just great. So that other point. And strangely for me, Zoya, when asked me that question, I said $1 million.
Да, что это за точка, где мне я, Дэрил, скажу себе, я сейчас знаю, что это та самая точка, где я доволен собой, и мой доход соответствует моим планам.
So where is that point where I, as Дэрил, am very satisfied with myself, and my expenditure is less than my income? So you have that. So you need to find that point.
Are you speaking of an amount of money or a feeling?
Это чувство удовлетворения, когда есть достаточное количество денег для чего-то, для чего?
It's a feeling that arises from satisfaction of enough money that you have for something.
For what?
For what?
И нам нужно определиться с этой первой точкой. Первая точка, где я неудачник, или как бы я себя ни называл, я убежден, что мне не хватает того, что я получаю, трачу я больше, и что это за чувство? Нам нужно разобраться вначале с первой точкой.
Ага. So the first thing we need to figure out is the starting point, where I'm a loser, I don't have enough, and I need to strive towards something to get there.
Где я трачу больше, чем получаю, и вот так вот обречённый я.
Okay, so I'm doomed. I'm spending more than I am making, and I'm just doomed, and I'm this unlucky loser. And I can't do anything about the situation. It's just that's what it is. You need to find that point.
Now, on this, when you say find that point, are you talking specifically again about that particular feeling or finding where it is?
Точка, в которой я чувствую себя убежденным, что это, ну, не переговорный, это пункт, ну, где я не могу ничего поменять.
It's a point where I'm having this inner conversation with myself of, okay, I can't do anything about it. It's just a bummer, you know, this is the situation, and it's, you know, it's a sad feeling, or
вот худшая ситуация, где я не верю, что это может поменять.
The worst case scenario where I can't believe that I can change anything.
Это худшее чувство о себе.
And it's, of course, it's the worst feeling about myself.
Right. Oh, I understand. Oh, I can get in touch with that feeling. Yes.
So we need to find this worst point.
Это не обязательно действие. Это можно ночью лежать там и быть в аду.
It's not necessary an action. You could be lying in the middle of your bed at night time and you could be experiencing hell at 2:45 a.m.
Вот надо припомнить это.
So you need to now bring it up in your memory. It could be a memory. And may I just interfere, not interfere, but add from how we trained with the, you know, our training. So we need to... картинку чувствовать.
Не надо, не надо. Ага. Просто ага. Вспомнить, когда было такое вот ужасающее чувство, ага. Что все, это приговор.
Okay, so just remember, bring it up in your memory when you had that terrifying feeling, like you've had a, you know, that's it, it's no way out, it's I don't know where to go, it's I'm sinking in debt, or it's just all horrible and it's I'm doomed, you know, no way out, you know, just try and bring it up in your memory. Who am I in this situation? It's hard to describe it, but what type of a person I am, and that's how we try and gauge the feeling. It's a question to try and find the feeling.
Какой я прилагательный?
Okay, it's an adjective. Who am I? Or what type of a person am I? And obviously, this word will describe a feeling. You know. Condensed. I don't wanna. Add anything to you. You must come out from you.
I'm searching for the word.
Maybe go there, close your eyes and just remember that memory.
Just feeling as if my efforts are futile or
In what moment do you realize that?
It was about 13 years ago. Mm-hmm. About 13 years ago, when I was getting close to retirement from the military. Mm-hmm. And I was living in a situation where I was living by myself because of where I was stationed at the time. And so I wasn't near my family, but it just felt as if all of the needs of the people around me and the things I wanted to make possible for them, there was just no way I could help them with my effort. So it just, it felt very futile, as if no matter how hard I tried, it just was not going to fix any of the problems. So it was a very dark time.
Нужно в этом времени выбрать какой-то конкретный эпизод, где вот это осознание на кульминации.
Mm-hmm. So you need to go into this timeline like it's a movie. Of that whole thing, that experience, and try and find a culmination, a peak point where you just boom and you realize.
И осознаешь о себе в этой ситуации, что я не могу помочь другим людям, и что тогда я-то какой в этом?
Okay,
что это означает?
Where you realize something about yourself at that point. So, okay, I can't help these people.
And what about you? What does it mean for you? Well, who are you in this situation? Why is it important about the life of other people? Why it's important for you and why you are not a good boy or man in this situation when you understand it?
Well, the responsibilities of a husband and a father, you know, wanting to make sure that my effort, my contribution was, you know, it was for the right people, you know. But it was just, I don't know, I think it's the natural obligations and expectations of a father and a husband for his family. I see these things that they need, these things that I want for them, and it's very frustrating when those things do not happen in spite of my effort.
I'm loser as husband and father, first of all. Или это
yes,
еще к другим людям имеет отношение? Well, по отношению к кому я больше всего лузер? Или кто я?
Okay, so in relation, is it with regards to husband and the father, I'm a loser, or does it involve other people, I'm a loser? But again, it needs to go with your feeling.
Myself.
Yourself.
My feeling. Judging myself for not being able to fulfill their needs in the best way.
Mm-hmm. What is this best way? Вот теперь идем вот в эту next point where it's the best way. You will say, oh, okay, I'm winner. Это что за такая точка? Я точно уверен, что I'm winner.
Okay, so we go to the other point now where I'm most definitely certain that I'm a winner. that I've freaking made it and I did it. I'm the best father and husband I
think. Я им дал все лучшее, что вот я хотел им дать лучшее, это лучшее.
I gave them all the best that I could have possibly given them.
Yes. Because there's no limit to that, is there?
Но он какой-то есть в голове какой-то лимит.
Okay, but within your head, do you have some limit where it's just yes, this is it, boom, I did it.
Yes, I can see that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now describe that.
So, the things that they need, like for school, clothing, so forth, as well as enough money to travel to visit them, and honor their birthdays, Christmas, the traditional things to meet those needs and at the same time not have to worry about groceries or fuel for the car, things like that. It's not a huge number, but it's enough to frustrate me.
In this next point, просто списком можно перечислить, что там есть конкретно?
Ну, сказал, там и борюща, и еда есть, и одежду, и школу я купил, и все.
Как это, когда я знаю, что вот это все теперь есть и будет? Вот что это за точка, что это за чувство? Okay. В какой момент жизни оно возможно осуществиться?
Okay, so when
реально осуществить такую точку, где есть это все и будет всегда. И вот okay, я знаю, что вот теперь точно не о чем волноваться. Ведь завтра будет другой день, когда дети будут другими. Я имею в виду, что дети изменятся, им нужна будет другая одежда уже через полгода. Там школа сменится на университет или другую работу. Жена захочет туфли на шпильках. Это примеры, просто ты суммируй по-своему.
Okay, so, at what point is there going to be enough where you say, okay, that's it, because tomorrow the school changes to university, the kids grow out of their clothes and need other clothes, and the wife now needs new shoes, and so find that point where
it's да, just, возможно ли эта точка? Где она?
Is it possible to find that point, and where is that point? How much money or
да, и я спокоен, что действительно это все будет как всегда.
And how much money? And I'm feeling safe that it's going to be always like this, and this is going to be just right, man.
I can see that amount. I can see the amount that it would take for anticipating the typical expenses of a family. Because now we have grown children, they're all grown now, and we have grandchildren, so it's never going to go away. But I can see an amount in my head that would make sure that all the basic needs are met, and there would be money to do all of the truly enjoyable things, birthdays and maybe a vacation, those kind of things.
Как эта сумма выглядит и где он находится, когда он знает, что она есть?
Okay, so how does the sum look like, and where you находишься как-то на физическом или на чувстве?
Что ты? Это же должно быть якобы чувство, которое мы принесли в удовлетворение.
Okay, so we kind of sum it all together: the amount that it is, and the feeling that you have when you have this comfortable amount and you're way in your life and within your feeling. And it's all together.
It's an amount that whenever I have an idea of something I would like to do with or for my family and friends, we can do it. I mean, it's just that it's a very peaceful feeling of knowing not just the things that are fun to do, but if a need arises. It's just very, very peaceful. Um, not like being Santa Claus or Father Christmas, but to be, to provide a sense of security for those around me. Does that make sense? To be a source of security for others, because I feel very secure. I feel very secure. I want that feeling of support, emotionally or otherwise, to be there for my family and friends also, so that they can go and explore the world and themselves like I have.
Okay, so a peaceful feeling that you will feel calm and peaceful when you have that sum of money.
It's the same feeling you have when you are giving someone you love a gift, you know, a gift that's wrapped up, that feeling you have. They haven't opened the gift yet. You know it's something that they love, but they don't know what it is. But that feeling you have when you're giving a gift that you know they are going to love, that's the anticipation I have, that feeling of, it's like you have a gift that you're waiting to give.
Все, мы, значит, сегодня не будем тратить время на саму прокачку, просто выписываем вот эти две полярности. То есть первая полярность — это когда я лузер, я не могу дать им саппорт, а второй вариант — это когда я уже дал им такой саппорт, что прям стал peaceful.
In today's session, for this session, we are not going to do a process like we did last time, although it's very, very important. In today's session, we want to show the polarity.
Да, нам важно записать сегодня, что первая точка — это когда я, Дэрил, я чувствую себя лузером.
Okay, now it's important for us to write down today. It's in the book. It's basically called the unpacking exercise, it's unraveling.
И погрузиться максимально в это чувство, и его нужно будет прочередовать, как мы на прошлом занятии.
Okay, so we need to get that point, write it out, that I am, as Daryl, a loser, that 13 years ago, you picture where you are sitting, and the whole feeling that you described, and,
Ты можешь его, да, самостоятельно ощутить это чувство, как сейчас вот с закрытыми глазами, погрузиться в это, что я ничтожество, лузер.
So you can now, with your eyes closed, feel that feeling as you were feeling 13 years ago, when you felt like a total piece of and you total loser, and the dead end feeling of hopelessness. Yes.
Yes.
Вот это чувство нужно просто сейчас за пометку записать, что вот какое это ощущение, когда я лузер, когда я чувствую себя лузером, я верю, что я лузер, когда я не могу дать им поддержку, финансовую поддержку близким, которая, как мне кажется, даст всем покой.
Okay, so we need to make a note, you need to make a note on your paper about this feeling. When you were that loser, that you couldn't give the financial support to your family, that would, according to you, give them peaceful stability, and you a peaceful stability.
То есть я не могу им дать эту peaceful stability.
I can't give them the peaceful stability.
Какой я, какое у меня чувство о себе?
And what feeling do I have about myself? That's an adjective. That I can't do that.
Of the next point, I can give them peaceful stability.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And then in the next situation, you can give them the stability. And what type of a person I am? It's again an adjective.
И что в этой точке ты интерпретируешь, что stability is peaceful feeling?
Uh-huh. And right? Yeah. And in this point, you interpret that financial stability equals peaceful, calm, tranquil feeling.
Okay, so in the first example, just a very deep, dark feeling of just worthlessness.
Worthlessness. Uh-huh.
Just worthlessness. Yeah, my electricity was turned off. My water was turned off. I was burning candles for light. But I did not share that with my family because I was, I was in a different geographic location. I didn't share that with you.
It's perfect.
Daryl, use this situation. It's a very good situation for processing. Very good.
So it was just worthless.
Я виноват во всем, что происходит вокруг. Самое главное, понимать, что в этот момент я ощущаю себя виноватым во всем происходящем в жизни. Во всех неприятностях, которые происходят. Виноват во всем я. И на левую сторону.
So let's say we'll take it on the left side. Not right now, we're just explaining to you.
Uh-huh.
Yeah? So we'll take it on the left side that I am to be blamed for this situation. I am worthless and just... terrible, and I am the one.
То есть выключается лопа, там гаснет лампа. О, какое чмо! Это я, подонок, виноват. Выключается вода в кране. О, боже, это я теперь не виноват.
The light switches off. Oh, I'm such a terrible, worthless piece of shit. It's my fault. The water switches off. Oh my God, it's all my fault. Look at that. Just even the water came off. It's my fault.
Да, то есть в этот момент важно осознавать, что я Дэрил. Не смотрю объективно на факты. Вот сейчас погас свет, а сейчас выключилась вода, а сейчас потекла вода, например, заток, например, от
сильного дождя. So it's important to realize that when you're in that state, that you don't look at reality objectively. Oh, now they switched off electricity. Now they switched off water. Oh shit, I have a flood up on my ceiling and the water is coming down.
And what always, it's my blame, it's my blame, it's my blame, it's my blame. Just not only fact, but...
But may I just clarify, the electricity and water got switched off because it wasn't paid, or it was just switched off?
I did not have the money to pay it, because I needed to pay the bills from the family.
И это увязать, что я должен был, я один должен был в одиночестве все это гарантировать, чтобы этого не случилось. Я один.
Okay, it's important to just take it in yourself that you believe that you alone is responsible for making all of these things paid up to scratch and happen.
И в этот момент я все интерпретирую. Я провинился, я виноват, я плох, я не тот.
Okay, and in that moment, I'm the guilty one. I'm the one to be blamed. I'm not the right man.
То есть, что бы ни происходило, я все интерпретирую в позиции, что я подлец, я зло.
No matter what would happen in your life at that point, I would interpret everything, including a leaking ceiling, that I am a freaking terrible piece of shit, man. I'm horrible. I'm horrid. I'm a nobody. I'm worthless. Yeah.
I'm alone.
And I'm alone.
Because I can't find the decision with my wife and everybody who close.
Who's close? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Поэтому, то есть осознать, что я верю, что я одинок в том, чтобы нести ответственность за всех вокруг.
So I believe that I am alone because in the fact that I need to carry responsibility for all those around me.
Я верю в это.
I believe in that.
И в этот момент я именно поэтому и буквально уничтожаю себя своим чувством вины.
And because of that, I'm almost destroying myself. I'm speaking from you, yeah? I'm almost destroying myself under the feeling of guilt.
В этот момент моя энергия уходит не на решение задач, вопросов, что нужно сделать, чтобы решить эти вопросы. И если я решаю вместе со своей женщиной, например, то мы пишем список, допустим, решений множество.
And at that moment I'm not deciding what decisions I'm going to be doing. Sitting with my wife together, and, for example, having a brainstorming session on the morning when the brain is clear and writing a whole list of all things that need to happen so we can, you know, get ourselves again going together. I'm not doing that. I'm just hammering myself under.
То есть вся моя энергия уходит на самоуничижение, на подавление.
All of my energy is going on self-hammering, self-beating, self-destructing, self-humiliating, that I'm the freaking piece of shit that did it all. I'm pathetic, you know? So all the energy is going on that.
И после этого я должен, это как если бы я сам себя бил по лицу, и у меня вместо лица кровавое месиво, я думаю на утро, мне надо как-то встать и идти улыбаться.
So it's almost if I've been plumbering myself with heavy fists, full power, and in the morning I wake up and my whole face is burst and swollen and, you know, just passing from pus coming out. And yet I believe that I need to smile, put a nice smile, cheese, and, you know, go and perform out there.
Мы просто изучили, как формируется чувство вины, для того, чтобы потом каждый мог самостоятельно с этой, работать с этой точкой, где сфокусировано чувство вины.
Okay, so we are showing in this, what we're describing is how to work with the feeling of guilt. So any person can go to that point and work with their own feeling of guilt.
Да, то есть понимать, не воспринимать со стороны, как бы наблюдать, как я формирую сам это чувство, и как сам же им уничижаемый, битый собой, затем теряю силу.
Okay, so,
я ни на что больше не остаюсь.
So to realize how I am generating this cluster of hectic energy with which I am hitting myself with after this heavy duty process of hitting myself with this thing that I've created, like a giant steel ball of atomic, like you said, like horrible energy. Now I'm plumbering myself all over. And then after that, I have no more energy for any creation, any creative expression of how to come out of this hole.
That's a perfect description of how I felt at the time. Uh-huh. I couldn't seem to focus on anything other than how the problem was affecting me. I could not even seem to find the energy to do anything about it. Mm-hmm. It was so debilitating, all the worry and the deprivation. I had no energy to do anything about the problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Вот, это первая точка, с которой мы работаем с первым вектором полярности.
Okay,
да?
So this is the first point at which we work with the first vector of polarity.
Uh-huh. А второй вектор, это где якобы я освобожусь от своего чувства вины. То есть в этот момент, когда мы уже разобрали, что на самом деле происходит в этой первой точке, мы понимаем, что вторая точка, это как мечта о том, что я приду туда, как человек, который... просто освободиться от чувства вины. То есть peaceful feeling это it means that I'm free from my feeling of guilt.
Okay. So now that we realize the first point, okay, we have that other point that you've been describing, that's something that you're striving towards. We need to see it as the other side of polarity, meaning this is not right, neither is this right. Okay? That when you get to this other point that you want to get, okay? You are, what you describe as a peaceful feeling. In fact, what's going to be happening is that you are not going to be having this feeling of guilt anymore, that you're running away from.
Да, то есть peaceful feeling — это когда я сбросил этот рюкзак чувства вины якобы. Я верю, что это будет так.
Okay, so the peaceful feeling that you're describing here is when you've dropped this huge, heavy load, rucksack, baggage bag, hiking bag, massive one, extremely heavy, filled with nothing but guilt. And when you drop that bag of that, you now, oh, that I'm gonna get that peaceful feeling.
То есть это свобода от чувства вины. Peaceful feeling — это свобода от чувства вины.
Peaceful feeling is freedom from the feeling of guilt.
На этом держится вся система.
On this, the entire system holds what's the main what's everything.
Конечно, потому что человек, каждый человек верит, что он найдет спасение от чувства вины там где-то в будущем, и поэтому и там никогда не окажется. Конечно.
Okay, so every human being on the planet believes that they are going to get be free from the feeling of guilt at some point in the future, but this point in the future never comes in reality. Therefore, this fantasy is going to rip us into two parts. My life right now, which is terrible, and just, and now, almost soon, almost there. What, this, I'm just going to do this and that's going to happen. And you're going to know what we're talking about. The whole world is what we're talking about. Everybody's in this. Okay? When I get this, then everything will be all
right. Я оправдаю ожидания всех и стану хорошим, и все мое чувство вины меня ставит.
Когда ожидание, ты что помнишь?
Когда ожидание, ну не знаю, ожидание других людей, которые ждут от меня.
When other, what's the word? When other people are awaiting something from you, and you make their wishes come true, and how do you say that?
When I promise that I will do it for you, you will believe me, just trust me, just wait a little.
And when you deliver on your promise, you оправдаешь ожелание. You make the wishes come true.
Fulfillment? You mean like fulfilling promise?
Fulfillment of promise? I'm good enough. I've done it, you know. It's mm-hmm. We need to get a phrase on that. But you know what we're talking about.
Yes. You know, if I could make an observation, in our last session, while we were talking about the problem, I just felt this pressure and everything in my throat here. Mm-hmm. And I know our last session was mostly about communicating. Mm-hmm. But in this one, it's taking everything I have to not scratch this area around my eyes. Mm. It's like, as we talk about it, my eyes are just... itching.
Now go for it. You need to, when you're going to be doing this, at some sessions, I've been ripping my skin open.
It just feels like the more, I just want to.
Это люди, да, часто это начинают, человек чешется, потом начинает плакать, у него начинается зуб, потому что...
A lot of people start scratching and they start crying. That's very deep stuff that we are touching onto, and that's why nobody wants to go here. But nevertheless, right.
Нам важно просто сейчас понять не сам, как процесс делается, а важно, с чем мы работаем.
Okay, for now it's important not to realize how we do the process, because we did the process last time, and mm-hmm. I'm sure we'll do another one that we will record for the people. But right now we're just unpacking, so we exactly know what we're working with.
Нам нужно прояснить, что почему процессинг не работает, когда просто объясняют, вот полярность, вот слева, вот право, давай чередуй.
Okay, so we need to explain why processing does not work for people when somebody just says, okay, this is the polarity, this is left, this is right, now alternate, do it.
Да, то есть здесь я чувствую себя хорошим, здесь я чувствую себя недостаточно хорошим, и чего-то чередую.
Okay, so here I feel I'm good enough, here I don't feel like that I'm good enough, and now I need to just alternate it so I can, you know, drop some, rewire some neurons, you know. It doesn't work.
Люди спрашивают, ну почему это не работает? Я же вроде все делал, как ты мне объяснила.
Some people ask, Zoe, why doesn't it work? I've been doing everything that you, you know, how you explained it to me.
Поэтому я так, ну, копаю, иногда прям вопрос вызывает, ну, что она от меня хочет? Она спрашивает, какое чувство, что тебе надо?
Yeah. So that's why Zoe digs, and people say, like, what?
Digs to feeling.
What feeling? What type of a person am I? I mean, we're trying to find the right questions in English. In Russian, it's just easy. Какой я? It's an adjective.
Which person am I?
You know, so we keep on asking. When people get frustrated with Zoe, why do you keep on digging at me with this feeling? What type of person am I?
I told you about my feeling. What do you want else? I don't understand you.
Yeah. So it's very important that we get to that clear two points that you've just described. You know, in the training, you'll see that we speak of picture, thought, emotion. So you free time freeze the 13 years ago, you in the middle of the night, for example, you got this final realization, oh shit, I can't do it anymore. And that's it. You reach a culmination of
Когда мы так дотошно, когда мы так дотошно изучаем, что это за чувство здесь, и что это за чувство здесь, и откуда я бегу, убегаю и куда я хочу прибежать.
When we with extremely detailed tenacity learn and study this feeling of 13 years ago where I was, and again that fantasy where I am trying to get to, or maybe not a fantasy, maybe it has happened, you know, detailed tenacity, very important where am I running away from and where am I running towards.
Да. И когда мы так детально разбираем, мы видим, что я бегу, вот эта траектория на самом деле, между вот этими двумя отрезками, это моя вера в то, что я убегаю к некую точку от своего чувства вины.
When we unpack this with such incredible detailed tenacity and like little blocks, we can see that this trajectory from that to that is I'm running away from my feeling of guilt.
То есть это отрезок, в котором, где я между вот этими двумя точками в своей голове, в своей проекции свободы от вины, я, это непрерывный процесс моего бегства вот в эту фантазию.
It's very important to understand that in my head, it's this pathway from my feeling of running away from my feeling of guilt is a never-ending fantasy which keeps on happening.
То есть, ну я, у меня два верования. Здесь я несчастлив, потому что у меня не хватает денег, а здесь я счастлив, потому что у меня якобы хватает денег.
Okay, so I have two beliefs. Here I am unhappy because I don't have enough funds. And
money.
And here I will be happy because I will have enough money.
Да, то есть в моей голове это два убеждения, что когда нет денег, я не счастлив. Связка между эмоциональным состоянием, счастьем, и материальным достатком, она неразрывна в моей голове. Okay. И мы это изучаем, как это покрывается чувством вины.
Okay, so in my head, the neural links and connections are so interlinked between not having enough money and happiness.
I'm unhappy when I don't have enough money.
And that's been built into us for our entire life from the time we were born. And we just need to know that.
А в другой точке я верю, что когда будет enough money, I will be happy.
And in this point, yeah. Why not?
И я знаю, что пока я верю, сама, сейчас сформулирую, что покуда я верю, что я несчастлив из-за того, что у меня нет много денег,
for as long as I believe that I will be unhappy, as long as I don't have a lot of money,
я связываю это со своим чувством вины.
I connect all of this with a feeling of guilt.
То есть мы разбираем, из каких на самом деле связей нейронных цепочек состоит чувство вины.
So we are actually unpacking from which neural link consists a feeling of guilt. Is it difficult?
No. So the starting point is not just the feeling, but a good, solid image at a time when I'm feeling that feeling. Is that correct?
Он, то есть это не просто картинка тоже.
Это проекция в моей голове. Это все моя фантазия. Что я несчастлив, потому что нет денег. Я буду счастлив, потому что когда они будут. И когда у меня их нет, я плохой человек. И все, я зло.
Okay, so it's a projection in my head. When I don't have it, I am just not good enough. And when I have it, I'm good enough. That's it.
Да, и это и есть чувство вины.
And that is the feeling of guilt.
Это и есть результат моего программирования всей моей жизни.
And that is a result of my programming for the duration of my entire life, which right. I've been deprogramming myself for a year, and it's a freaking hell of a ride, let me tell you.
И пока мы не прочередуем обе проекции, какими бы безумными они ни были, я несчастлив, потому что нет денег, и я счастлив, потому что они есть.
And until we alternate through a myriad of processes on that and this, when I don't have money, I'm unhappy, and when I do have money, I'm peaceful and happy. Until we do myriad, loads and loads of processes.
Они просто будут раскачиваться, этот конфликт внутри будет всю жизнь раскачиваться и создавать все больше шар чувства вины, и все.
If we don't do
только разрастается вина.
The conflict between these two things, the amplitude of polarity will get wider and bigger throughout life. Until, it's huge. And that...
Это просто вины, чувство вины, которое растет всю жизнь.
Okay, so basically,
это амплитуда, которая...
It's an amplitude which keeps on growing the duration of a person's life of a feeling of guilt.
чтобы нам зайти внутрь как бы синапса и увидеть, как это сообщение напрямую связано, напрямую, ну, скажу.
Okay. In order for us to get into the synapse, individual or a few synapses, and to see how the connection is actually formed.
Да, как, чтобы это рассоздать, эту синаптическую цепочку.
In order to unhook and disconnect the synapse connection within the neuron.
Мы делаем вот эти процессы.
We do this.
Вот это чередование.
We do this alternation processes.
То есть чередование этих двух образов, лузер и виннер.
The alternation process of these two visions we have, the loser and the winner.
Да, и в итоге это, если мы думанием, почему другие процессы не работают иначе, когда я думаю, вот мне надо вот это отпустить, или вот это отпустить, это невозможно.
Why most other processes don't work? When you kick in your head, when you kick in your thinking head, oh, I need to let go of this, or I need to let go of that, and then everything will be all right.
Это просто еще больше думание усиливает внутренний конфликт и вот эту натяжение этих полярностей.
The thinking itself builds up on the internal conflict that we're speaking about and strengthens the tension between the two. And moves them even further apart. So
эти точки взаимоусиливающие друг дружку.
These two points are interconnected, and they increase the strength on each other.
Mm-hmm. То есть как полярности две перчатки. Помните, вот пример физики Эйнштейна. Вот
the example of Einstein, two gloves.
Да, где одна точка отражается, зеркально отражается в другой, то есть все.
Where you have one point that's mirror.
В квантовой физике все так работает.
In quantum physics it works like that, where you've got two, like one glove and mirror reflection of this other glove. And...
И процесс думания может только усиливать этот конфликт, он не может его нивелировать.
Okay, so the process, the thinking processes, the thinking. The only thing it does is increases the amplitude of this whole mess, this two polarity. It cannot do anything else but that.
Да, а сам вопрос, ну, процесс чередования образов, это процесс освобождения от страха перед чувством.
Ага. So the alternation process that we did last time and that we'll still do and keep on doing, what it does, it releases the fear in front of the feeling, in relation to the feeling that you have.
То есть я принимаю оба этих чувства. Здесь я так себя чувствую, здесь я так. Конфликт заканчивается и постепенно интегрируется.
And what it happens is I accept this feeling that I was feeling 13 years ago, I accept it, okay? And then this feeling that I'm striving towards, you know, so you alternate it and then you accept it. But there's nothing we can do for you to accept it now until you actually do this process. And what happens is they integrate.
Заканчивается война с собой, не чувствую.
Basically, the war between the two feelings you have ends.
I felt that last time. I mean, that is exactly what happened last time.
Uh-huh.
As we were alternating, the images came into balance with each other. And so that's exactly what I felt the last time we did a process.
Uh-huh. So you integrated, you really were describing some and we felt it with you, because when we start doing the process together, we were feeling everything. I felt my throat closing, and so we actually experiencing the same thing you're experiencing, even not with by time and space.
Но это физически ощущается очень, ну, трудно пройти через это, как пытка внутри тебя, это как пытка, и поэтому люди так не хотят эти процессы.
Yeah, it feels like torture. To go through this is like torture, and that's why many people are not ready to they'll They'll read literature on esoterics, they'll talk about Illuminati, aliens saving us.
То есть такое сильное сопротивление, потому что на самом деле люди говорят, что это рвется, умирает. Это так и есть. Потому что рвутся нейронные связи.
It feels like people say, and we experience that it feels like
small death.
It feels like a small death. When the neural links rip, when these neural connections have been ingrained into us our whole life, rip.
Люди это не осознают, конечно. Они говорят, что как будто какое-то умирание, я не хочу в это идти.
People, of course, don't realize what's really happening. What they're feeling is they're saying that it feels like a small death. And that's why they're like, oh my God, this is a resistance. They don't want to go into it. But what Zoya's experienced, there is the light at the end of the tunnel. It took her 13 years.
То есть я, когда была алкоголичкой, я настолько была психопаткой, я все время вот так тряслась, разговаривала так очень быстро, невротично, вот так разговаривала. По-другому не могла.
When she was an alcoholic, she was in like a neurotic state, constantly shaking and twitching, and she spoke like she just described. She couldn't speak any other way.
И у меня не было выбора, кроме как закрывать себя в комнате изнутри, чтобы делать процессы. Потому что иначе я бы убежала везде, или напилась, или что-то начала ломать, или чесать, или вот так.
She didn't have any other choice eventually than to lock herself in a room for 5-6 hours a day and to do inner processes. Otherwise, she'd run away, she'd get drunk. She said to me, she'd pour a glass of wine, and she said, I'll have it, but first, when I come out of the room in 6 hours' time.
То есть я все время тряслась, есть как синдром Туретта такая болезнь, и я примерно вот в этом же состоянии была, все время тряслась. Если я не буду пить, ну то я просто не могу находиться в этом.
Okay, it's like a syndrome of Tourette. I don't know if you know it, but she always kept on shaking.
Yes.
She couldn't stop herself from shaking. That's your polarity, how much it has amplified between the two. Yeah, it's an amplitude.
И когда человек вот в таком уже состоянии, ему либо умирать уже, либо закрывать себя на замок и прокачиваться. Но когда люди состояние получше, то у человека всегда есть выбор, чтобы сказать, я лучше подумаю, легкие какие-то практики поделаю.
So when you get to that state, you have two choices. You either die, you kill yourself, or you die, or something, or you lock yourself in a room and you start processing heavy duty, full power. But when a person starts feeling better,
другие люди чувствуют себя лучше. Как правило, получше, не так ужасно.
Okay, so when other people don't quite get to that bottom that Zoya just described, they're feeling all right. So then.
И человек всегда может сказать: я лучше подумаю, помедитирую.
Yeah, then people say, so when they don't reach that low state that Zoya spoke of, they just say, then I can, I'm not that bad. I can just think about things and I can just meditate, or I can talk about aliens or flat earth and things will be all right, And then I'll have my joy.
Просто не будет делать. Не будет он эти процессы делать.
He just won't do these processes. They just don't want to do them. They're not interested. Bad things do get worse.
Ну, конечно.
Of course.
Да. Так вот, то, что мы сейчас разбирали, мы это очень подробно разобрали. Это первая часть работы, да, что это чувство вины, и это. Просто оно выглядит по-разному, но это одно и то же.
So what we've just described now in the earlier today with you, it's a first part of the process. A very, very important one, but it's the first part of the process. I call it the unpacking exercise. You basically write. It's more of a writing journal story.
Что за всеми этими образами лузера и победителя стоит чувство вины.
Behind both visions of loser and winner, I have a feeling of guilt.
И даже если мы это детально разобрали, если дальше второй части работы нет, процесс с этим выяснением не начался, ничего не поменяется.
So even if we detailed unraveled the situation, this first part, and with like we did it with you, and we with great tenacity have described both situations 13 years ago and the dream in the future or a certain thing that happened. If we don't do part two of the exercise, the alternation of the exercise, nothing changes. Nothing.
Потому что это мириады нейронных связей, которые с детства.
Because it's a myriad of neural links, a myriad. Of neural links, which are coming from the childhood.
Я понимаю, как это работает, например, но я не могу изменить это. Я буду это чувствовать.
I understand how it works, but I can't change anything.
Я это чувствую. Ну что я поделаю? Ну я это чувствую.
I feel it. What can I do? I feel it. There's nothing I can do.
Что хочешь,
Дэрил? Yes, Дэрил. What do you want to say?
Well, so if I understand correctly, and this is a very powerful insight to me, is that when I felt at my most worthless and consumed by guilt, which made me feel helpless, if I don't break this connection, even if I make enough money and feel peace that I can meet other people's needs, it will still be motivated by the guilt. So I may tell myself I feel peaceful, but really, even that is plagued by the guilt if I don't break this connection. Is that correct?
Yes. Вообще никакого отношения к реальности не имеет эта вера. Никакого.
It's got to, this,
мы сейчас это распространим, сейчас примеры
this,
сделаем.
This, we're going to give you some examples now, but this has nothing to do with the reality. And that's
совсем
why,
никакого отношения к реальности.
Nothing.
Это просто верование, которое базируется на том, что ты не оправдал мамины ожидания. Если бы ты хорошо учился, Дэрил, почему ты непослушный мальчик? Посмотри, как ты заморал одежду. Ты не принес мне пятерку. Ты не сходил в магазин.
Okay, so this is basically coming from, it's important where these things got roots from. When Дэрил is a little boy, and mommy is saying, oh, Дэрил, you haven't got an A+ for your test, you haven't gone to the shop, you haven't, you know, not good enough, man. What? That's not good enough. You haven't done this. Why haven't you done this? You know, it's all coming from that.
Это лежит на таких глубинах, когда мозг только формировался.
It's lying at such deep depths when just our brain starting to form. I can't remember anything before the age of 9. And that means I had tremendous trauma.
Мы только подходим к этим, возрасту.
I could say that I've had a good family and my, you know, I was not, but the more I do work with Zoe, I realize that I was, it's better that I was actually given to an orphanage. It's better that I was given to an orphanage to what I have gone through with my good parents, as I claimed that they were, you know, I was fed and I was given to a kindergarten, I was given over to a school and, you know, my dad bought me Lego, you know, gosh, this kid's far worse out there. But after doing many, many, I'm realizing that I was better off given to an orphanage because I was almost not noticed between my dad's and my mom's feet because they were so busy proving their self-worth and blah, blah, blah. But we're going to give some good examples.
Да, то есть затем вторая часть процесса, когда ты уже сможешь самостоятельно вот так все чередовать, следующая часть процесса будет круговой процесс.
So the second part of the process, after you've described these two points, like we were doing today, you do the second part of the process, which is alternation, and we did it last time. And then there is the third part of the process.
Это многопозиционный процесс.
It's called the third part of the process is the multi-positioning rounder, where you see the situation from another point of view.
Another
person's point of view.
Так вот, мы сейчас просто проиграем это как... Ну, я сейчас, по идее, по-хорошему, когда уже ты сам сможешь, после первой части чередования, вот то, что мы сейчас разобрали.
Да? Okay, after the alternation exercise of the first part that we've just unraveled,
допустим, следующий этап, сразу же, хорошо бы сразу же делать от лица уже другого человека, который там участвует в какой-то ситуации.
Okay, the best you can do at that time, after you finish part two of the exercise, is immediately going to part three of the exercise and do it from a third point, another person's point of view, who was somehow, somewhat involved in that situation.
То есть... я сейчас со стороны вот людей, которые оценивают тебя, повыступаю для провокации, как бы.
Okay, so Zoya is going to play a role of somebody that judges you, just to provoke.
Yes.
Provoke you.
Да, можно так.
Yeah.
Раскопать, как бы, unpack, to see what's inside.
To see what's inside. Yeah. So she's gonna push into a sore point.
Да, но когда ты сам с собой работаешь, вторая часть работы с собой в том, чтобы представить себя этим другим человеком. Сейчас я со стороны, а на самом деле нужно в процессе, теперь я этот человек и есть. Какое-то okay, ощущение, so, чувство, какие образы.
Okay, so for now Zoe is going to play a role of this third person, you know, another person. But when you do the work with yourself, you need to then get into I am this person, or I'm Sarah,
да,
or I'm my boss,
persona,
or my...
которая говорит с Дэрилом.
I am that
теперь
person.
Теперь я персона, а Дэрил со стороны.
So what I do is I usually tap myself, you know, I usually tap myself here and I say I am Mayor Sergeant this who speaks to Дэрил now, or Sarah, I'm now Sarah. You know, you remember, yeah? So I just tap myself. So you actually, what feeling? What picture I'm looking at Daryl and
то есть именно многопозиционный процесс нам дает как бы можно сказать стопроцентную объективность. Но
okay,
это,
okay,
ну,
so, okay, so it's very relatively speaking, but multi-positioning process gives us a full objective picture.
То есть, грубо говоря, невозможно увидеть, как работает чувство вины Дэрила, пока я не изучу всех соучастников, как они себя чувствуют, как они ведут себя, чем они живут, какими верованиями.
So it's impossible to study Daryl's feeling of guilt unless I look at it from other people's points of view who are surrounding Daryl, how they're living, how they're experiencing, what are they feeling.
Да, что им движет, как он себя чувствует.
What is Daryl feeling and what is moving Daryl to do certain actions.
Это все нужно из всех людей.
And you need to study that from other people's points of view to get a holistic picture on the situation. Yes, Daryl.
So it's just like not being able to tickle yourself, right? So looking from another perspective.
Да.
You have to look at it from another perspective to really see the big picture, to tickle yourself.
А потом это станет привычкой, постоянно так, именно так видеть свою реальность от лица разных людей. И порой будет ощущение, что говоришь с человеком и видишь себя, и это я от первого лица, и этот человек тоже я. Такое будет ощущение. То есть, чем больше будет процессов...
The more you're going to do the processes, it's going to be like almost second nature. You're going to see, this is I am, and, oh, and this person is...
I am too. То есть, I am, who am I? Daryl or Sarah, I don't know. Everywhere I am. Это будет, это как... частью восприятия реальности.
It's going to be almost a natural part of perceiving our reality or your reality for you.
No, that makes sense. Absolutely.
But I think it's going to get more clarity when Zoe does a little example.
Да, сейчас вот мы работаем с первым верованием, что я, Дэрил, я недостаточно счастлив, потому что я недостаточно богат.
Yeah. So we're gonna work with the first point. So I'm Daryl. I'm not happy because I'm not. I don't have enough wealth.
Итак, вот мы без света, без воды, и я говорю тебе, что ты нехороший человек, Дэрил. Ты нас подставил просто.
Yeah. So now we
закрывай, закрывай,
close your
просто.
Eyes. Close your eyes and don't open them for now. So I am now in the room and I'm saying to you, Daryl, you've put us into this terrible situation. We don't have water, we don't have electricity. It's all your fault.
Это ужас. Я не хотела с таким человеком вообще задерживаться по жизни.
Yeah, it's terrible. I didn't want to be living with such a person for the rest of my life.
Знаешь что, это уже далеко зашло. Я уже не прошу себе там жемчугов и золота, но сейчас уже беспредел, дорогой друг.
Yeah, this has gone a bit too far, Daryl. I'm not asking for myself gold and diamond necklaces, but not to have electricity and water. You've gone way too far, my boy.
И если ты мне предложил бы сейчас что-то вместе там решать и обсуждать, ты уже такую попытку делал что-то вместе решать и принимать решения, как-то разруливать ситуацию.
Yeah, if you're going to suggest that we're going to sit and brainstorm together, you know, to try and you know, solve the situation, you know, you've done this already a trial before, where we try to do something together.
У меня встречный вопрос: с чего ты взял, что я обязана нести с тобой ответственность, делить с тобой ответственность за все, что происходит с нами?
I have a counter question, an opposing question to you. From where the hell did you get this idea that I need to be taking the responsibility with you for the situation?
Просто мы изучаем чувства сейчас.
Okay, so we're just studying the feeling right now.
Какой я дыру?
What?
Когда мне говорят, что ты ответственен за все.
What am I as Daryl, adjective? What feeling do I feel about myself when I get told as Daryl that I'm responsible for the situation and I'm responsible for everything?
Вот найди вот это чувство в горле, сглатывание пошло, okay, да, такое so, тяжелое so, сглатывание.
So, as you just swallowed in your throat, find that feeling. What is it? Describe it.
Just worthless. Why even try then?
Теперь второй вариант. Дэрил, мы вместе, милый, все хорошо, у нас есть сейчас такие обстоятельства, в которых нам нужно решить, чтобы было тепло и нам было что пить.
Ага. Дэрил, now we're going to the second point.
Нет, point, not point. The same point.
Same point. Same point, but now we have a different view here. Daryl, you know, we're together, man. Everything is all right. So what? There's no electricity, there's no lights. We have food and we have water on the table. Man, everything is all right. And we're together, and that's the most important thing.
Нам нужно сейчас вместе с тобой принять решение, как разрулить эту ситуацию, как нам получить воду, свет, еду на следующий день,
yeah,
и как сейчас переночевать, пережить эту ситуацию.
Yeah, we just need to sit together and, you know, and have a little brainstorming session, how we can get electricity and water switched on tomorrow, that it all works. And for now, we just need to, you know, worry about one thing. How are we going to, you know, get through the night? And do we have enough warmth? Maybe we're going to go get some blankets, extra blankets from a friend, or you've got some sleeping bag in the garage. Let's work out the tonight, and then tomorrow, you know, we'll work it out, man.
Какие чувства?
What feelings do you have now?
Much more relaxed. I can... I'm focused on finding solutions instead of a hopeless problem.
Полегче, да? Немножко полегче.
Much lighter, hey?
Yes, lighter, definitely.
На заднем плане ощущение, что все равно она пытается меня поддержать, но на самом деле это я говно.
Do you have in the background a little voice saying to you, she's just trying to... You know, give me hope of support, but in reality, I'm still a fucking piece of shit.
Yeah, like if it got worse than it is now, you know, or how much would it take getting worse before you don't, you know, you can't focus on, you know, the good things. You can only focus on the bad things too.
With на пути, если чтобы я уже перестал фокусироваться на позитивном, и просто все говно.
То есть сейчас мы просто осознаем, что в обоих случаях, как бы внешняя ситуация не выглядела, как бы человек себя не вел рядом, то на самом деле это ощущение вины, чувство вины никуда не отступает. Оно может быть послабее, но оно все равно там же.
Okay, so what we want to bring to your attention is that no matter what the external situation is, in part one we had the other person's, you know, your wife saying the words of blame, it's your fault, or versus encouragement and everything is all right, we're together, let's find a solution together. In both of those situations, both of those outcomes, there is still an inner feeling of guilt and feeling of... just you know, I'm not good enough in both of those. Can you feel that? Can you
see that? Мы просто это сейчас наглядно рассматриваем, чтобы увидеть, что оно просто есть. Оно не, от этого невозможно внешние обстоятельства, чтобы люди это поменяли, чтобы это близкий человек поменял. Это есть. И это поменять можно только вот этой монотонной работой.
Okay, so we just quite graphically shown you that in both scenarios, the feeling of guilt is ever present. In the second part, it's less. But if we, when we asked you a bit further, you said no, it's still there. You know, if things would have got worse, I would have definitely focused all. It's part of the nervous system. This feeling of guilt of I'm a piece of shit. I'm not good enough. It's ever present. It's part of our nervous system. And without this monotonous work that we've described, we cannot get rid of it.
То есть мы сейчас посмотрели, что поведение человека извне, то есть есть вера, что я, Дэрил, верю, что деньги мне помогут, нечто извне мне поможет.
Okay, so we have a I Дэрил, have a belief that something from outside such as will help me, such as money.
Да, such as money. Mm-hmm. То есть мы сейчас увидели, что something as a relation, там кто-то из membership, да, там не, ну то есть никто не может ничего изменить, как бы человек себя ни вел.
Okay, so no matter how the other person externally outside of you, in your case your wife, would have done carried herself, whether she did the blame and shame part in one, or whether she did a supporting, encouraging...
Supporting or suppression, it's...
Yeah, supporting or suppression. Whatever she did, nothing would change. Can you see that?
Yes.
It's not the external person that's going
to... То есть интенсивность чувства вины меняется, но само чувство вины никуда не девается.
The level of intensity of feeling of guilt changes. In the first part, it's tremendous, and in the part two, it's lessened, but it's still there. Can you see that?
The guilt still affects the image.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Так почему же, если мы убедились сейчас, что оказывается извне отношения не поменяют ничего, то почему вера в то, что деньги что-то поменяют, если живой человек своей тактикой не изменил
okay.
радикально?
So we've just through this exercise we've just seen that another person through
это самый близкий, любимый человек.
Your most closest, your most loved person, if they played part one or version one or version two, nothing changed.
Пусть зевает, Дэрил.
Yeah, Дэрил, yawn. Let it come, yawn.
Не удерживай, потому что кислорода не хватает для переработки новой информации. Ну,
scratch, yawn, scratch, do, go for it. Okay.
То есть для переработки нейронных цепочек очень много кислорода требуется.
In order to rework and rewire the old neural links, a lot of oxygen is needed. And the body is trying to grasp some air. So give it air, do what you need to do.
То есть буквально перерождать мозг.
You're basically rebirthing, you're literally rebirthing your brain right now as we're doing this exercise. That's why you need to yawn. Okay, so I'm yawning myself. So basically what we're trying to say is, even if your closest person could not change this feeling of guilt, how on earth do you think that having any amount of money is going to change it either?
Mm-hmm. Так как же мы тогда идем во вторую точку, во второй пункт теперь?
Okay, so now we're going to the second part on our trajectory, where, remember the second part, where I have enough of money. Yes?
Да.
We're going there now. Go there now.
И вот в этой точке я верю, что сейчас у меня достаточное количество денег, чтобы оправдать ожидания там, своей жены, своих детей и внуков.
Okay, so now I'm at this point where I have enough money to be good enough, that phrase that we're trying to look at, that deliver, that fulfill people's hopes of my wife, of my grandchildren and my children. I fulfill their hopes and wishes. They, you know, I'm good enough for that. We'll find the phrase for you next time.
Так, mm-hmm. И мы берем первую ситуацию, где там тот же Christmas, да, как пример приводим,
okay,
на праздник подарки дарить.
Yeah, so let's just go into, for example, a situation where it's Christmas now, it's time of giving gifts, mm-hmm. Yeah?
И вот ты даришь теперь дорогие подарки, какие все хотели, близкие.
And now you're giving expensive gifts who all your close relatives are wishing for.
Не говоря уже о том, что ты заплатил по всем счетам за свет, воду, воздух, за всю свою жизнь,
за право жить. We're not even talking about that you have paid all the bills, of course. So the electricity, the water, you've even paid for oxygen and for your right to live.
Mm-hmm. И вот дети берут подарки, дети, внуки, и говорят, ой, спасибо, спасибо, дорогой дедушка, спасибо, дорогой муж, спасибо, теперь ты, это точно, все приобретения, все, что нужно было, ты теперь нас обеспечил всем, что мы хотели.
Okay, so your grandchildren take the gifts, your children take the gifts, it's a whole big family gathering, your wife, Sarah takes a gift and they all one by one say, oh, Daryl, thank you so much. This is exactly what I wanted. You have fulfilled all my wishes and my hopes to come true. Thank you so much, Daryl.
Mm-hmm. Какие чувства?
Okay, what feelings now you have?
I'm still thinking of what's the next thing they'll need.
Что-то нужно, теперь я что-то не додал, да?
Something I haven't given them. Something more that they'll need next time. Maybe a drone.
Yeah, this is today. This is today, but what about tomorrow?
Да, tomorrow I want a new car.
Yes, a Lamborghini, please.
Well, and I think of it in a positive way, like I'm very happy when we are opening these gifts, but at the same time, I'm like, am I going to be ready if help is needed tomorrow, or if you know there's something new tomorrow,
И вот мы первую серию tomorrow еще не наступило, мы закрываем только today, закрываем дверь, okay. Как кино, знаете, фильм заканчивается и титры пошли. На самом пике счастья вроде как и титры пошли, okay. Дальше не будем смотреть, что после этого.
Okay, so you know, like in the happy moment of the movie, the titles, the movie ends suddenly and the titles appear and they start rolling.
Да, so, titles побыстрее.
Yon.
Titles как можно быстрее, потому что следующий момент уже не такой счастливый, и надо быстрее сказать титры.
So the titles are moving so fast because we quickly want to end it right here. It's happy end. We don't want to show what's going to happen in 5 minutes time. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. И поэтому титры пошли. So, но реальность другая.
So the titles at the end of happy movie is running, moving, but. In reality is different. It's not a movie.
Да, то есть кино не закончилось, наступило действительно tomorrow, и tomorrow ты идешь мимо ванной и слышишь, как разговаривает дочка, да, дочь?
So tomorrow now the reality has happened, now tomorrow, today has passed, and tomorrow you wake up and you're going past a bathroom, and you hear your daughter. You got a daughter. Yeah.
Дочка разговаривает с внуком.
And you hear your daughter speaking with your grandson. You have a grandson?
I have granddaughters.
Aha. So your daughter is speaking with your granddaughter.
Да, то есть дочка разговаривает с внучкой в ванной, и ребенок говорит: "Мама, зачем?" Шепотом говорит. Они не знают, что ты после Крисмаса так рано встанешь.
Okay, so they didn't know that after Christmas you woke up so damn early, and the little granddaughter is whispering.
И она спрашивает, почему он все время хочет что-то подарить и спрашивает, что я хочу. Я не могу сказать, я ребенок, я не могу сказать, что я хочу. Я хочу, чтобы он меня обнимал, прижимал. Я не знаю, что это.
And the little granddaughter says, why does Daryl keep on asking me what I want? What I want. I don't know what I want. I want my grandfather to just give me a hug and spend time with me and walk with me and love me. I don't know how to describe it. I don't know what it is, but he keeps on asking me what I want.
Я просто хотела однажды к нему подойти и сесть к нему на коленочки и просто погладить его, подержать за руку, погладить его лицо. Но он так бежал в своей суете, куда-то про какие-то зарабатывания денег говорил, что он меня даже не заметил. Я просто запуталась у него под ногами.
Yeah, I came to him and sat on his knees one day and wanted to stroke his face, but he just put me down on the ground and he says, no, I'm busy. I've got a deal here and a contract there. I'm so busy. I need to go and make money. When he just ran away somewhere, but I just wanted to stroke his face.
И дочка говорит, ты знаешь, дорогая, я тоже все детство ждала, что он спросит меня, как я себя чувствую, что у меня на сердце, а не что я хочу.
And then your daughter, and now you hear your daughter speak to back to your granddaughter, and your daughter says, you know, little one, I also waited my whole life for Papa to, you know, ask me, what am I feeling? What am I feeling? Really ask and have a sincere conversation with me. But it never happened. He was just so busy all the time.
Dad, yeah.
I just wanted my dad to, you know, to really have a sincere conversation with me, but he just kept on running all the time.
Всю жизнь он меня спрашивал, что я хочу, а не что я чувствую.
Yeah, my whole life, dad asked me what I want and not what I really feel.
И я тоже не знала, что с этим делать. Как будто я какая-то тупая, пустая кукла, которую нужно наряжать, что-то ей покупать, а не услышать, какие у нее слезы внутри, mm. чем она живет, о чем мечтает.
Mm. I felt like I was this this fake doll that somebody needs to
a stupid
fake doll that somebody needs to dress and give things to and versus a real person who has feeling who and versus my dad asking me about what am I crying about, what am I feeling, what am I experiencing, what am I living with right now, what am I going through.
То есть вместо отца я видела человека, который always busy.
Yeah, instead of a dad, I just saw a person who is always busy.
Не человека, который чувствует и спрашивает о чувствах, а человека, который всегда просто бежит и мечтает.
Yeah, not a person who is asking about feelings and feels himself, but a person who just like a machine is keep on running for some money to get some money.
Вот поэтому, поскольку меня не спрашивали, я тоже внутри стала пустой и оглушенной. И сейчас мы с тобой об этом говорим, дочь. Хорошо, что мы хотя бы так говорим, потому что со мной никто так никогда не говорил.
So, little one, it's good that we're speaking about this because my dad never spoke to me about these things. So, I also feel empty and hollow inside. But at least it's good that we're chatting together.
А в те моменты, когда папа пытался со мной говорить о чем-то, он больше это делал, потому что тоже как будто пытался мне заплатить, восполнить какие-то долги, а не потому что он хотел действительно почувствовать.
And in the moments that Dad did have a conversation with me, he almost, it felt like he did it from the point of repaying some debt to me or giving back to me something that he needed to do versus really just having a sincere and open heart feeling and crying together and just feeling and having a deep you know, conversation.
То есть вот она вторая серия фильма, где первая серия — это хэппи-энд, это то, что мы всю жизнь смотрели. Какой там тачка, разлетаются деньги, они счастливы.
Yeah, so this is the second part of the movie. In the first part we had the happy end, where in the movie you have a hot car arriving and Big Bugs Bonanza.
Это программирование на протяжении всей жизни. Все голливудское кино на этом строится.
The entire Hollywood film is built on this. This is the programming that we have received for the duration of our entire life.
Но после того, как закрываются двери кинотеатра, начинается реальность, где просто одинокие люди с деньгами или без не способны слышать, чувствовать друг друга. Mm-hmm.
But as soon as the movie ends, the happy end ends, the reality kicks in and you see incredibly wealthy people who have vast wealth, really vast wealth, who are incredibly lonely and are not able to feel other people feel.
Открыть свое сердце, поделиться своими чувствами, open, спросить другого, ничто не могут.
They're not able to open their own hearts to express their own feelings or ask another person to share their feelings. They're not able to do that.
Теперь два чувства сравним. Первое чувство, когда мы уже проанализировали во второй точке, то есть первая ситуация, где я достаточно много заработал, чтобы они все получили.
Okay, so now we're going to analyze. We have this first part where I have made enough money to gift and give my children and my wife everything they need to.
И мы увидели, что на заднем плане остается опять чувство вины, что я должен сделать еще завтра.
And when we saw that on the background, we still had that lingering feeling of guilt, which stated, what else do I need to do tomorrow?
Or after tomorrow.
Or for the next, birthday or Thanksgiving or next Christmas. What else? And every single day going forward, this same question will keep on arising in your head over and over again.
А во второй ситуации, когда отец, дедушка слышит в ванной разговаривающую дочку и внучку, что это за чувство?
And then in the second situation, second part of the situation, where a grandfather hears his granddaughter speaking to his own daughter, what is that feeling?
That she is correct. That, I mean, she is making a very good point.
И тогда какой я?
Okay, what type of a person I am? Adjective. Who am I? What feeling am I?
Someone who misses the point. Someone who has. Someone who does not understand, someone who is disconnected from the people around me.
Not only people, myself.
Also myself, yeah?
Yes, yes. Because what you were saying was 100% correct. Of how I was as a father and how versus how I'm trying to be as a grandfather. You know, but yes, her words in this example show that I'm disconnected from what the people around me really need. So yeah, disconnected. Just or I'm missing the point, missing the priorities, focusing on the wrong priorities that are not solving the problem. Or not problem, but I'm not giving people what they need. So disconnected.
Okay, so our priorities are those priorities which we have been programmed for our entire lives. We cannot relook at them unless we deeply analyze where it came from and do a myriad of processes. Mm-hmm. Because our priorities are formed from belief.
Да, конечно.
Yeah, of course.
Да. И третья ситуация, когда хорошо, я, допустим, внучка, которая уже понимает, что с дедом у меня никакой сердечной связи никогда не будет. Какой-то он очень странный, он все время говорит про деньги, он все время сфокусирован на том, чтобы иметь больше. Ну, я поймаю тогда с него. Uh-huh. Я хочу.
So now we're going to go into another scenario. It's number three. So I'm the granddaughter. My granddad is strange. I can't connect with him. He keeps on asking me what I want. So, okay, I'm going to get the most out of him, whatever I can get out of him.
И вот я просто прихожу и говорю, дедушка, купи мне, пожалуйста, машину. Я современная леди. Ты хочешь, чтобы твои дети, внуки были успешными, статусными?
Yeah.
Купи мне достаточно хорошую машину, потому что я не могу переездить вот на этом старье. На этой...
Дочка или гранди?
Уже гранди.
Okay, so your granddaughter sometime in the future comes to you and says, granddad, you know, I'm a cosmopolitan woman. I really want to present myself well. I'm looking for a good job. I need to arrive in
there. Я не могу делать карьеру без нормальной машины.
Yeah, I can't build a career without a nice car, a normal car. Please, can you just buy me a car? And it's got to be somewhat all right because, you know, I can't come on a piece of shit and into an office job because they'll laugh at me.
Я это не произношу как внучка, я не говорю, что все равно ты единственный человек, который все время говорил, что что-то должен заработать. Я не пытаюсь там себе задавать вопрос, как я сама это сделаю, там, как я спланирую эту покупку, что мне для этого сделать.
Yeah,
so я просто это очень легко к деду, а к кому еще? Он все время что-то мне тыркал подарки.
So I, as a granddaughter of Daryl, because I've had this conversation with my granddad for many, many years, it won't even come to my head, how must I think of making money for my own car? I'm a big enough girl to do this now, I'm a grown-up woman. My granddad, my whole life, kept on asking me what I want, what the hell, I'm coming to him and I'm telling him what I want.
Ну, ты должен купить мне машину и все, точка.
You ought to buy me a car, period.
И теперь дочка приходит и говорит: пап, так совпало, тоже мне тоже нужна машина. Вообще-то, ну а кто это должен делать? Кто должен-то? Я, что ли?
Now your daughter comes the same time and she says, oh shit, man, it seems to be something in the stars, because I also need a car. Who else must buy me a car? I must buy myself a car. I don't have a husband or whatever. You need to buy me a car.
И жена такая: опачки, дорогой, а ты вообще видишь, что у нас стены уже просто облезает краска? Сколько лет этому ремонту, мой милый?
Now Sarah comes and says, hey, my darling one, can you see the walls are peeling off? The last time we had a renovation in the house was 27 years ago. We gotta get this place fixed up. It looks like shit.
Ты мне не говори, что это мы вместе сейчас должны делать, решать что-то. Давай, а кто должен-то? Ты всегда говорил, что это ты должен. Вот и делай.
Yeah, don't come and tell me now that we need to figure this shit out together. Always you told me that it's your job to figure these things out, so I'll deliver.
Какие вопросы?
What questions you have?
Папа, дед, давай, гони монетку. Ты же всегда говорил, что монетка нас осчастливит. Хорошо.
So now wife, daughter, granddaughter, all coming and saying, hey, deliver. Give us cash, man. You always said cash is going to make us happy. Deliver now.
Давай, давай, бабки.
Quickly. Money.
Какое чувство?
What feeling?
Like I did not focus on what was important, even when I knew what was really important. Like I sent the wrong message.
What type of person am I, as Daryl, who realizes that, who's feeling that? What is the feeling, in a word?
Just angry with myself. Angry.
Но на что именно злой?
What are you angry about?
That.
Что ты не можешь.
Did not. I was using the material things to show my love and affection, but angry because I was not communicating the things that really were important, which were my feelings and their feelings. And I knew that the whole time, but I did not know how to communicate the feelings. So I just replaced that communication with material things. Mm-hmm. So instead of emotional connection, it was with materialism.
Ну и все, you showed your love through material things. Okay, give me money. I didn't see your love. То есть при чем здесь любовь? Yeah, ты показывал, что у тебя есть деньги, говорил, что это есть любовь. Хорошо, давай мне такую любовь дальше. Я не могу уже ничего чувствовать.
You didn't show me love. You said love is money. I'm not able to love either. Give us money now. Now.
Mm-hmm. I don't have any feelings already.
Yeah, I'm not feeling any feelings. I just want money from you. Give it to me.
Yeah, once again, it's just feeling hopeless then. Like, I put my energy into the wrong thing.
But you have invested your whole life into it.
Показать, что любовь — это деньги.
To show that love is money.
Or using money to show love.
Все, ты получил деньги, давай деньги. Я ничего не могу чувствовать, кроме желания хватать твои деньги.
So you received money, so now hand over the money, because I can't feel anything except for the money.
Да, только except greed.
I can't feel anything except the greediness for money, because this is what I've learned.
Mm-hmm. Money has become the love.
For you, maybe love. For me, it's not love, but I don't need any love from you already. I just need only money.
Yeah. Love is maybe just for you, money, but for me, yeah.
It's become the expectation of, oh, this is how you can show me love, because this is how you've always shown me love. So if you love me, you will give me this.
Yeah.
Ну так люби дальше, давай. Если ты меня любишь, давай.
So carry on loving me. If you love me, hand over.
Right.
Какой я?
What am I? Feeling, attitude?
Just, once again, just worthless then, because that's not what I was trying to do. Just like, okay, then why was I even trying? You know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's what you требует, или что?
To give what they demand.
What about okay?
Well, okay, you said okay. Okay is to give.
Or not to give.
Well, I was giving because that's the only way I knew.
Mm-hmm.
But that is not what I was, you know, the money was the tangible thing because I could not express the emotional thing.
Uh-huh.
And so they mistake the tangible for the emotional. And then there's no real connection.
Да, поэтому ты не знаешь, дорогой дедушка, ты не знаешь, как я ночами плакала одна в постели, когда я хотела твоей ласки, твоей нежности.
Yes, my dear granddad, you don't know how I kept on crying night after night in bed alone as I wanted love from my granddad.
Вместо этого ты подарил мне мишку. Ты сказал, что это дорогой, хороший, качественный мишка.
Instead of that love and tender love and care that I was searching for my grandpapa, you gave me a teddy bear, and you said it was a really high quality branded teddy bear that says, I love you, when you rub its tummy. You gave me this bear.
Mm-hmm.
Так что теперь вместо мишки дай мне машину. Я уже там, я уже умерла.
I have died.
В той ситуации я уже стала мертвой.
In that situation, I died. So now, give me a fucking call.
Right. No, you're right, because with my children, that is exactly how it went, because I didn't know. But with my grandchildren, I have a completely different interaction with them as I've gotten older. But with my children, I still have the same problem, but I am making an effort with my grandchildren. It's different.
Это поэтому мы и взяли специально grandchildren, чтобы показать, насколько больнее увидеть уже правду, когда в молодости ты бежишь, вообще ничего не понимаешь, дети там. Mm-hmm. Просто...
So that's why we have taken the situation with grandchildren to see further down the line. Because with children, you know, in your youth, you couldn't see many things, but with the grandchildren, you're now having deeper realizations.
Да, поэтому когда уже притормаживаешь с годами, ты уже начинаешь видеть боль ребенка, внука именно глубже, намного, чем собственных детей.
Yeah, so when you slow down over the years, you start to see the pain of your grandchildren more clearly than of your own children.
Mm-hmm.
Поэтому слезы внуков, более наглядные, как бы скрытые слезы внуков, они больше острее чувствуются, чем слезы детей, когда... Uh-huh.
So the tears of grandchildren are much more clearly seen, very clearly seen and experienced than the tears of your own children.
Именно поэтому мы представляем, что внуки уже выросли, и взрослые, они стали вот такими отчужденными и холодными.
And
только тачки теперь.
And that's why we have taken the grandchildren to show how they've grown up further down the line, and they are so cold, they are not able to feel anything. They just want the big bucks bonanza, give the car, money, hand over.
Ну что в реальности они еще дети.
Because in reality, right now, they're just still children.
И они еще не убиты, они еще очень открыты.
And they haven't been killed yet, emotionally killed. And they're still able to feel, and they're still waiting for the feelings. Their hearts are still open, and their doors are still wide open for that love, the feelings to come in.
Вот. То есть мы сейчас просто это сделали, со всех сторон просмотрели ситуацию для того, чтобы просто прочувствовать, что все прошито чувством вины.
So we've just looked
все варианты.
We just looked at the whole situation in all of its variables from all from people involved, and we saw that in first part and second part, in all scenarios of first part and second part, everything is stitched from with a feeling of underlying guilt. Can you see that?
Yes, 100%. Yes.
Просто сегодня была такая демо-сессия для наглядности, что из чувства вины самим осознанием, то, что мы сейчас сделали, это маленькая капелька в море.
Okay, so it was a very demo, it's like a demo session to show that everything is got that underlying feeling of guilt. Yeah, you can open your eyes, yeah. You can see that everything is filled with the feeling of guilt. And we've just did a little drop in the ocean.
Да, чтобы осознать, что все прошито чувством вины, и какое множество процессов нужно сделать, чередований, чтобы от этого освободиться.
Okay, so we just did a little drop into the ocean.
Не освободиться, а слой за слоем просто снимать хотя бы.
To realize that how many myriads of processes, alternation processes we need to do, hundreds and thousands, those are thousands, in order to this...
То есть чувство вины будет уходить очень маленечко.
Levels. Feelings of guilt will be like peeling off the onion, hey?
Да, только the next. Миллионами слоев.
But millions of levels, layers. And we're going to be peeling
it. It will show up in other places too. It will show up in other things and at a different level, exactly. A deeper level. Sometimes.
And then when Zoya kept on asking me, every morning she kept on asking me, so what am I feeling? And I'm like, I'm fine. You know, the usual American, I'm fine things. No. And she really like, what are you feeling? I'm like, Zoya, I have this tightening feeling in my neck. And then we go and we search for it. Okay. I don't know what it is. No, what? But if you knew what it is. And she says, no, but how she got to it usually. But if you were a little tiny cell, and you're sitting in this tight spot, what is it feeling tight about? And I'm like, man, I don't know how I'm going to pay my bills tomorrow. And, you know, and then we start unraveling and we do the whole process. Then we do the alternation. So basically what we find the biggest thing worry today. And through the worry, through the external worry, the biggest one, we find the program that underlying it. And then when we shatter that through alternation, a few things shatter as well. It's quite amazing how it works. And then the amplitude of guilt gets less and less and less. The amplitude of that. Yeah?
So you could start with, if I understand correctly, so you can start with asking, what are you physically feeling? And then zooming in on that physical feeling to see what that makes you think of.
What triggers the physical feeling and then the emotion.
It's equal.
Equal.
And what's the emotion? Yeah. So you might feel a physical sensation, but as you focus on it, what comes to mind when you're focusing on that and then looking at that in from the perspective of what's causing that?
What are you tight, for example, causing?
Like, I feel a pain here. When I think about it, I'm not communicating with my wife like I want to. How does that make you feel? or what is the word to describe how you feel when you think about that? And then you've got something to dig into with the processing. Is that correct?
Yes. And then,
просто мы говорим о том, как важно много-много чередований делать. Важно каждый день делать. Хорошо бы первое время, особенно первые три месяца, делать каждый день утром и вечером.
Okay, so we realize how important to do the alternation process, which is obviously in the training, the exact how to do it. And for the first 3 months, if you can do one in the morning and one in the evening, it's ideal. Yeah, it's really, really ideal. Try and get to that. But at least once a day, but twice a day will be better.
Я хочу просто показать, как в худшем случае получается. Если мы вот сейчас разобрались, чего состоит чувство вины. Хорошо, мы разорвали цепочку «деньги – это и есть счастье», или «деньги – это и есть выражение любви».
So she wants to show the worst-case scenario. So now, during today's exercise, we have untangled that the cluster of happiness is money,
Love is money,
and not is having a feeling of guilt.
Да, мы разорвали, как бы чуть-чуть надорвали эту связь.
We just somewhat ripped that connection, yeah, a little bit.
Но все это мы помним, что все это базируется, лежит на чувстве вины.
But we realize that all of this basis, the guilt,
это
is lying underneath. It's like a foundation of all of this is the guilt.
Поэтому, если мы на этом закончили, например,
and let's say we just finished this exercise now,
и, допустим, вот я, Дэрил, после этого, о, такая ясность, я ничего дальше с собой не делаю.
And I'm Daryl, I have such clarity, chicky-pooky, everything is sweet, and I'm not going to do anything further than that. I got incredible clarity. Thanks, guys. I really had an amazing epiphany realization. Boom, off I go now.
То есть, что я после этого начинаю делать? Я, понятно, что мне не нужно, оказывается, делать подарки. Вот так я начинаю заключение вот такие обсуждения.
So the conclusions that I'm going to start doing as Daryl is I don't need to give gifts anymore.
Мне надо как-то выражать любовь детям, внукам, и я пойду их любить, как-то их пойду любить.
And I need to express my feelings to my grandchildren and children. And I need to show my love.
Они же на самом деле хотят, чтобы я был тендер, такой весь, да, нежный.
Yeah, they in reality want me to do be tender, to be this feeling guy, to be able to listen to their feelings. That's what I want. I've got this realization now. So I'm going to go and give it to them.
И все это движет мной из того же чувства вины, которое я не прорабатывал, потому что я не работал с нервной системой напрямую через чередование.
But because I haven't done the alternation processes, I'm doing all of this that we've just described, that you're going to go and give your children this love and this feelings, but the underlying basis is still the feeling of guilt which you haven't worked through.
Я, грубо говоря, иду там приласкать ребенка, ну как-то мне надо его приласкивать. Ой, моя внученька, какая ты хорошая.
Ой, my granddaughter, I'm giving you so much love and so much care, you're so beautiful, you're so awesome.
И физически я как будто выражаю тепло, а на самом деле выражаю фальшь и чувство вины.
In a physical level, on a physical level, I'm showing love, but on a personal inner level, I'm being false because I'm feeling tremendous feeling of guilt.
Да, я выражаю вину и фальшь.
I'm expressing guilt and falseness. I'm a liar.
Просто плохой актер.
Like a bad actor.
So the motivation, whether it's with material things or affection, the motivation under it is still the guilt. It's like if someone switches from hiding from their feelings with alcohol or switching over to hiding from their feelings with marijuana. They're still hiding from their feelings. So exactly. If guilt is the motivation, it doesn't matter if it's through material demonstrations of love or physical demonstrations of love. It's not love, it's just doing it out
it's
of
just demonstration.
It's just demonstration. Yeah. You're acting.
It's not sincere.
Потому что чувств ничего нет, кроме вины.
Because from feelings, nothing exists except guilt.
И для того, чтобы начать какие-то другие чувства чувствовать, помимо вины,
and in order to feel any other
мы не
feelings,
говорим, что мы исключаем вину. Это будет одним из чувств естественных состояний.
We're not saying that you need to exclude guilt right now, you know. But in order to feel other feelings besides guilt, because there will be many feelings,
Да, и в том числе, но это будет длительный путь, когда я потихонечку начинаю воспринимать реальность разными чувствами.
It will be a very long path as I start to experience the reality with a multitude of feelings. And guilt being one of them. But it will be...
Мы не убегаем, мы наоборот все принимаем.
We're not running away from anything. We're rather accepting everything.
И тогда, где-то там, спустя годы, с такой длительной работы, я действительно начинаю искренние чувства испытывать к миру, к людям. Там, где-то, мы можем сколько угодно говорить про любовь, но мы ее не можем испытывать из этого состояния. Об этом просто нужно забыть на время.
Okay, so we can talk our faces blue about love, but we cannot experience love. None of us can until sometime in the future, after many, 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 many processes, you will start to experience a multitude of feelings, which, you know, then we can talk about love.
То есть первое время...
We need to forget for love.
Я могу говорить о своих чувствах, это уже огромный шаг. Какая там любовь? Тут,
yeah, never mind
стал
love.
Искренним, хотя бы сколько-нибудь честным, а не, больше не вру, столько okay. прикидываясь любящим. Это уже прорыв.
So, what love? You know, the first big step that we are starting to do is we are having the ability to speak about our feelings. It's already the first grand step. Park love out for now. Just being able to speak about our feelings.
Не, Алла, my feelings, my deep feelings.
Yeah,
я могу их распаковать.
I can unpack my feelings. I can unpack them. I can unpack my own feelings. I can start speaking about my feelings.
Да, it's already, искренне, без страха, it's already, что меня осудят. Это огромный шаг. Это очень большая работа.
Sincere, speaking about it sincerely without feeling that somebody is going to judge me. Is already a massive step.
Да, потому что если я не боюсь быть искренним и что меня за это осудят, значит я уже освободился от чувств вины.
Because if I'm sincere and I don't have a fear of somebody is going to judge me, it's already a releasing myself from the feeling of guilt.
No, I see that, and it's just like you're perceiving everything in the world through, like. Guilt lenses. Mm-hmm. So you don't even know what's really behind it because everything you do is motivated from this energy instead of the highest or higher energy. Exactly. Everything you do is based on guilt in this case.
And what we're talking about is the entire collective consciousness of the whole planet is carrying this, which you've just unraveled. That's why it's so similar for all of us. It's the same.
And during our time, it occurred to me, even when I was a child, what I was going through and the fact that no one was connecting with me about my feelings. And so if someone doesn't demonstrate to you as a child what the correct way is to express or show concern for feelings, you don't even know how to do it when you're a grown-up. And if you're in a place where you don't really have money, that's a much easier thing to do, you know, to learn how to express through money than it is to express through you know, communicating feelings. If you don't know what that, if people can demonstrate how to make money, but no one's around you demonstrating how to show feelings.
Да, потому что, ну как, я должен откупиться, если я ничего не могу чувствовать, но я ничего не могу. Ну значит, я тогда хотя бы что-то куплю взамен.
Yeah. So
это откуп.
So I need to buy my way out. If I can't feel anything, then at least I can buy my way out of the situation of this.
Ну, это как признание своего рода, что я не могу дать тебе никаких чувств, ну, возьми хотя бы вещь.
It's like almost when you... Yeah, I can't give you any feelings, but at least take a thing, you know?
Mm-hmm. Or...
I can't give you anything else.
Mm-hmm. Or it's just like if the people around you are not demonstrating how to get the feelings, the suppression out... And all they're demonstrating is how to cover it up with alcohol or whatever. You can only follow the example that you've seen. Is that right? So if no one's showing me how to get these feelings out and heal them, all they've shown me is how to cover them up with money or wine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, and the whole world is like that.
That's beautiful. I mean, that awareness is a wonderful awareness. Yeah, the first session that we did, I was very nervous because I was afraid of what I might personally go through. But I just stayed focused on whatever I was going through because I wanted to believe that the outcome would be worth it. And it was. You know, I just kept reminding myself, do I want to keep going forward with this same frustration in my relationship, or am I willing to do anything to make it better? And that's what I kept focused on. And it was worth, you know, the fear before the process, it was worth it at the end. And that's why I was very excited about today also, because it is worth it.
Yeah. So awesome. Mm-hmm. Awesome. I think we'll end it on this and we'll do another session and then maybe we'll do some alternation or...
Да, просто хотелось бы попросить, чтобы вот он сам попробовал сделать и написал нам ответ или аудиосообщение, что получилось, как получилось.
So Daryl, we really, really, really want you to go in your own time, but preferably today, whilst it's all fresh, to go and do this alternation exercise of the two scenarios.
Да, вот с этим лузер и бизнес.
The 13 years ago, picture, thought, emotion, where you are, you're lying, the peak of the situation where you're feeling that emotion, you freeze frame of the movie. You're lying in bed, it's whatever time, and you're feeling, oh shit, I'm doomed, I can't provide anything, the electricity is cut, blah, blah, blah. You know, so you find a picture, a freeze frame picture, emotion that you're experiencing
and
thought at that moment, the thought that you're thinking, the emotion that you're experiencing, and then you really bring
thought, for example, I'm fucking loser,
yeah, else. Yeah, and the feeling that you're experiencing, that's the emotion, what person am I, or you know, we've already identified that, and the picture that what you're seeing in front of you, you put that on your left eye. And then it, you know, it will alternate, maybe then take it to the right eye, and then for now just stick to the left, and then on the right side you take this either a situation that happened in the future where you have enough, or your fantasy, like this Christmas, and you have this fantasy feeling that you experience that, oh shucks, you know, I've got everybody the present they want. This one is that you and you're looking in their eyes and you freeze, take a freeze frame. You're looking into their eyes and everybody sitting in this as a patient and you know that.
И какой я в этой ситуации, когда все, о, спасибо, берут
подарки. And in that situation where everybody's coming and thank you, Daryl. Wow, what an amazing present. What type of a person I am as I'm experiencing in that split second, you freeze it and what am I experiencing? You know that.
И вот это прочередовать. Дальше пока не идти. То, что мы разбирали со всех сторон сегодня, чувствую.
So don't go anywhere else into other people, how they see your granddaughter, daughter, and another day, and tomorrow, and in the bathroom situation. Don't go there. Just this 13 years ago and this situation. Again, picture, you see them in front of you coming to say thank you. Or, you know, and then you alternate, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You breathe, you yawn, you scratch, and then we want you to leave us a voice note, or maybe you can describe it to us in the next session, or leave us a voice note tomorrow. And you know, you want to get to that, boom. You want to get to a point where you don't see what happened 13 years ago, and you don't have this.
Ну ты помнишь, потому что
remember.
В прошлый раз обе картинки.
Where both pictures they disappear and you actually feel that integration, where they become one, yeah.
Да, то есть когда нет никаких чувств, не маячит никаких картинок больше.
Where you don't have any feelings that are ripping up, we don't have any more pictures that are from the past or the future.
И везде одинаковое чувство, как тогда.
And in both situations, left right, you have the same feeling, like in the last session, and then you do this, Daryl. You open the top part, I do it with my nails, and then you get the white light, and you get the torus, and expanding, and then you give us a voice note.
Главное все записать после этого и рассказать нам, что получилось, что нет.
Important to write down afterwards, journal, and then just share with us what happened, what feelings, and what realizations. Okay.
No, that.
If you got any questions, I'm just on the other line.
Gotcha. Okay, no, that's beautiful.
5 kilometers away. Sorry?
Okay. How many kilometers?
15.
What is it like? Wow, that's a long way. No, that was really beautiful. You gave me some amazing insight. And so this is going to be fun. You know, it's going to be worthy.
Yeah.
I don't know if it'll be fun, but it'll be worthy.
Good, man. Good.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you again.
Thank you, Daryl. Thank you so much.
Okay, man.
All right. Bye-bye.